Class 7, Subject Science. Chapter is Transfer of Heat. Lecture number 2, Teacher Mustafa Kazmi. The things that we are going to discuss and learn today are which appliances we use in our daily life, which work on convection, difference between conduction and convection. Okay, as you can see, this is a diagram of a convection current. These are the warm air which are rising, and these are the light air which are sinking. Warm air rises because it is less denser and is not heavier, it's lighter. But cold air is dense and it has a higher weight than the warm air. As you can see, this is a picture of a geyser, a domestic geyser that we use in our daily life. Okay, this is an interior of a geyser. This is a water tank of geyser, a tap and a collector. The water is stored here where it is heated. When the water at the bottom is heated, it becomes warm and go upward. And there are two things in profitable by this water going upside. First, when we open the tap, we'll get warm water. And second thing is that the cold water which was upside had come down to become warmer. So due to this reason, due to convection current, we get warm water so frequently, so rapidly in our taps. Okay, as then second example, the second application which works on convection current is an AC, an air conditioner. AC throws out the cold air which pushes the warm air to get inside the AC, so it becomes again a cold air. And by this convection current, AC cools our room so rapidly. As you can see, these are hot air balloons. These also fly due to convection currents. Now I'll show you how they fly due to convection currents. Okay, this is a very big stove. It throw out fire and warm air. So, due to the warm air, as we know, the warm air rises up. As the warm air rises up, the balloon is in a proper shape so that the warm air goes out. Okay, when the warm air is trapped in the balloon rises because the warm air rises. Okay, now come to the second topic, difference between conduction and convection. Okay, conduction and convection are two different things. Like convection occurs in gas and liquids, but conduction occurs in only solids. As you can see, convection is the rise is of the warmer air or warmer particles and the sink of the cooler particles, while convection is the transfer of heat from a molecule to another molecule, like from an atom to another atom. Okay, now I've written on the board differences between conduction and convection. Okay, the first difference is conduction occur in solids while convection occur in liquid and gases. In conduction particle transfer heat, while in convection warm air rises and the cool air sinks. Okay, conduction, all type of solid cannot do conduction. Only conductors can do conduction, while in convection all type of liquid and gases can do convection. Thank you.